This problem looks pretty fun. We're going to find the values of C such that the area enclosed by the parabolae, ooh, fancy pluralization of parabolas there. I think this is going to be good. Y equals x squared minus c squared, and y equals c squared minus x squared. Make sure that that area is 576. And again, we're finding the C values that are going to make that happen. Again, a sketch is a nice idea. I don't know what C is, but if you have C squared, then that's going to be a positive number. We're subtracting a positive number off of x squared. That is going to shift a parabola down c squared units. It's upward opening, so it'll look something like that. This parabola is going to open downward because of the negative on the x squared term. It's going to be shifted up c squared units. So that's an equal distance up here, c squared units. It's a downward opening parabola, and this whole thing should be symmetric. Now the area in between those two curves is this shaded thing right here, and that area is going to be given by an integral. We'll have to find the limits in a second, but the top function is c squared minus x squared, and the bottom function is x squared minus c squared. Bracket those things up, find the limits, and that's going to be your area. Now, as always, finding the limits is going to be about finding these intersection points. These intersection points represent the largest and smallest values of x for this given region. To find those intersection points, we can just take the two functions and set them equal to each other. If I add x squared to both sides and add c squared to both sides, we get x squared equals c squared, or x equals plus and minus c. Well, that was pretty fun. So this x value here is c, and that x value there is negative c. So our limits go from negative c to positive c. Let's evaluate this integral and see what we get. If we simplify, you'll notice that you get negative 2x squared plus 2c squared. Integrating negative 2x squared is going to give you negative 2/3 x cubed. And now remember that c is just a constant. So this whole thing is just a constant. And when you integrate a constant, you just tack an x on it. We can evaluate that from negative c to positive c. And what do we get? Plugging in our upper limit of c for x here gives us this term. Subtracting and plugging in our lower limit of negative c gives us a whole lot of negative signs. And let's see if we can simplify just a little bit. C squared times c is just c cubed. Negative c, that quantity cubed, is going to give us an extra negative sign. That's going to cancel with this negative sign, but we're still having a third negative sign that's going to stick around. Over here, multiplying c squared by negative c is going to put a negative on this term. But that negative out in front is going to make this whole term positive. Combining our terms and correcting the fact that I wrote squares instead of cubes there gives us this. We would need to find a common denominator between negative 4/3 and 4. That would mean changing this term to a 12/3, which is going to give us an 8/3 c cubed. That is the area between these two curves that we drew above, but we were told that we needed that area to be 576. Let's hope these numbers turn out to be good. We need this area to be 576. Now, solving this equation would involve dividing everything by 8. 576 is fortunately divisible by 8. That gives us 72. And then if we multiply both sides by 3, we get c cubed equals 216, which is pretty cool because if we take a cube root of 216, we get c equals 6. And that is the answer to the problem. In other words, if we look back at the original problem, if we had the parabola x squared minus 36 and 36 minus x squared, and we found the area between those two parabolas, that area would be 576 apparently. And okay, I guess we need to tack this on at the end. You'll notice that we would get the same parabolas, x squared minus 36 and 36 minus x squared, if c itself was negative 6. So while c could be 6, c could also be negative 6. That would give us the same parabolas in the original problem, and we should get the same area between those two parabolas. So technically we have two answers to this problem, and now we are finished.